I know it's our job and all, but these resistance types sure do use and abuse us, don't they? It's like they see us as a couple of gophers or something.
No complaining about your work. Exchanging information with the resistance is a vital part of our mission. Besides, being a gopher is safer than being locked in combat all the time. Not dying beats dying any day.
Yeah, that's true.
She wants intel on A2, does she? Where should we start?
We could check out the energy reactions generated during battles. The fusion reactors of androids and machine life forms shut down when they're destroyed. And we can detect the energy release during that process. We're the only units doing any combat missions in this area, right? So if we detect any stray energy reactions, it probably means A2 is involved. Yeah, okay. We've got some readings around the abandoned factory. I'll put it on the map. That's A2's handiwork, I bet. But I'm not picking up any sign of A2 herself. Huh? What in the world?
Pod, help me out here.
Analysis. It is believed to be a data log related to Yorha Unit A2.
What's the data?
The data log has been irreparably damaged. Further analysis is impossible.
Why do a bunch of machines have A2's data?
A2B, I'm picking up other reactions. We should check them out. Okay, I think that's the last of the data chips.
Pod, analyze and collate the information from those chips.
Analysis complete. Data set contains information about Yorha Unit A2. Collating with data from other chips. Stand by. Collation complete. The contained data is a debriefing report for the Pearl Harbor descent undertaken during the 14th Machine War.
No kidding.
That operation was carried out by the Yorha generation that came before us, right? Anyway, mission complete, I suppose. Let's get back to the Resistance camp. Wonder what that was all about. Something must have been up between Anemone and A2.
Something's darn easy to talk about, especially for a soldier who's been fighting that long.
I guess so.